say, Patchen?
Special guests for the evening include the reigning Miss California Teen USA, Micheline Bonilla.
The lights are shining just for us.
Miss Texas Teen USA, Christy Wright.
Come on, girls.
From the Lone Star State, Miss Texas USA, Stephanie Cuny. Our television hostess, Kim Tones Dutton. And our master of ceremonies, Bob Eubank. Convention Center. Guy Reck presents the 1990 Miss California USA pageant. Featuring our master of ceremonies, popular television game show host, Bob Eubank. And our television hostess, former Miss USA, Kim Tones Dutton. Brought to you by Chevrolet and your Southern California Chevrolet dealers. And by Epi Products, the people who bring you Epilady and a growing line of other beauty breakthroughs. An original New York seltzer, light and refreshing. The choice is clear. And by Lunch Bucket, microwavable meals, a proper hot lunch. Bonds, finally a store that works. Tonight's show is a tribute to the Guy Reck story. Miss California USA 1987, Lori Dickerson. Miss California USA 1988, Diana Magana. And Miss California USA 1989, Christina Faust. And who will be the new Guy Reck girl? Well, she's California USA. Join us now, live on stage, as we look for this year's winner. Featuring the Alan DeWalm Dancer. California USA 1989, Christina Faust.
Brand new day, brand new day, brand new day.
1987, Lori Dickerson.
USA, brand new people, brand new day. Who will be this USA? Brand new people, brand new day. Who will be this USA? Brand new people, brand new day.
Three Guy Rex girls, and they are all from California. California, USA.
You can ride up the popular aerial tramway or cruise about town in a convertible. There's lots to see and do here in sunny Palm Springs. And there's even more to see on the Miss California USA pageant. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this message from your Southern California Chevrolet dealers.
Put on your thing. Ladies and gentlemen, here's our master of ceremonies, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the 1990 Miss California USA pageant. You know, all of our 95 delegates have been here in Palm Springs for 9 exciting days, and now they're gathered together on our stage here tonight, ready to compete for the $70,000 in cash and prizes. And of course, the coveted title of Miss California USA for 1990. So if you're ready, why don't we get underway as we look for the next Miss California USA. Now remember, tonight's winner will enjoy a year of representing the Golden State, plus she will also represent the state of California in the annual Miss USA pageant this next spring. So as you can see, the winner tonight has a lot to look forward to. But first, why don't we get ready as we meet our 95 statewide delegates in the 1990 Miss California USA pageant Parade of Cities.
Representing Alta Loma is Amy Rittenhouse. Say hello to Carrie Burrows from Anaheim. The delegate from Auburn is Rosa Pinguello. Please greet Diana Kiss from Bel Air. Our representative from Bellflower is Jill Christine Ferris. Here from Beverly Hills is Natasha Pavlova. Welcome Deborah Stewart from Brentwood. And now we have Kristen Ray Cleveland from Carmichael. Representing Catalina Island is Monica Getchell. Say hello to Tamara Trosper from Cathedral City. The delegate from Century City is Patricia Jacks. Please greet Julie Marie Miller from Cerritos. Our representative from Chatsworth is Jennifer Lido. Here from Citrus Heights is Kitty Tuck. Welcome Kathleen Whitney West from Concord. And now we have Jolie Lalo from the Conejo Valley. Representing Contra Costa County is Tracy Ann Fox. Say hello to Christy Piles from Corona. The delegate from Cudahy is Asenath Tucker. Please greet Jennifer Serpa from Danville. Our representative from Del Mar is Wendy Zastapol. Here from DeVore is Sheila Smith. Welcome Kathy Sawyer from the Diablo Valley. And now we have Linda Elkin from Diamond Bar. Representing El Toro is Tanya Lay Rios. Say hello to Jennifer Elizabeth Graham from Fair Oaks. The delegate from Gilroy is Cynthia Lee Nelson. Please greet Bonnie Johnson from Glendale. Our representative from Greater Huntington Park is Patricia Barba. Here from Greater Sacramento is Billy English. Welcome Kelly Prather from Greater San Diego County. And now we have Yvonne Ileana Hansen from Greater South Bay. Representing Granada Hills is Susan Ann Sweet. Say hello to Deneen Marie Rice from Hollywood. The delegate from Inglewood is Michelle Margina Moody. Please greet Tamara Christine Daniels from the Inland Tri-Cities. Our delegate from La Cunada is Linda Thompson. Here from La Costa is Yvonne Spinetto. Welcome Casey Watkins from La Jolla. And now we have Robin Gail Suter from La Mesa. Representing Laguna Niguel is Jamie Barnard. Say hello to Michelle Lene Stewart from Lakewood. The delegate from Long Beach is Michelle Marie Francis. Please greet Bethany McDonald from Los Alamitos. Our representative from Los Angeles is Bonnie Bergstrom. Here from Malibu is Lamour Francis Barnett. Welcome Elizabeth Alvarez from Manhattan Beach. And now we have Lorianne Garcia from Mission Viejo. Representing Monterey County is Yvette Michelle Dalton. Say hello to Angeline Ashley from Moreno Valley. Our delegate from Northeast Los Angeles is Rosalina Delgado. Please greet Tanya Newbold from Newport Beach. Our representative from North Sacramento is Danielle Short. Here from Northridge is Anna Marie Dalmaton. Welcome Martha Christina Bernay from Norwalk. And now we have Shauna Lynn Searles from Orangevale. Representing Oxnard is Robin Breda. Say hello to Kirsten Chatterton from the Pacific Bay Area. The delegate from Pacific Palisades is Christina Lynn Randall. Please greet Cherry Poonsalon from Palos Verdes. Our representative from Pasadena is Gretchen Sue Hines. Here from Paris is Brenda Marie Hamer. Welcome Kathy Lizarreras from Placencia. And now we have Laura Rishan Winter from Placer County. Representing Port Hueneme is Heidi Poland. Say hello to Catherine Mulder from Poway. The delegate from Rancho Cordova is Alexis Acosta. Please greet Lori Sue Castile from Redondo Beach. Our representative from Roseville is Shannon Lindy Hawes. Here from Sacramento is Donna Clark. Welcome Carrie Hansen from the Saddleback Valley. And now we have Tara Deanne Sillert from San Clemente. Representing San Dimas is Carmen Lisa Barbosa. Say hello to Kathy Roten from the San Francisco area. The delegate representing the San Jacinto Mountains is Nicole Danielle DeSanto. Please greet Kelly Swartfiger from the San Joaquin Valley. Our representative from San Luis Obispo County is Molly James. Here from San Ramon Valley is Christina Senna. Welcome Tammy Ann Alvarez from the Santa Clarita Valley. And now we have Tricia Morris from Santa Monica. Representing Santee is Deborah Ann Solinsky. Say hello to Sean Doreen Jacobson from Simi Valley. The delegate representing the South Coast is Diane Lynn Schock. Please greet Tammy Terrasas from Summit Valley. Our representative from Sylmar is Shauna Morrow. Here from Tarzana is Sally Bell. Welcome Susan Dolores Nissim from Temecula Valley. Diane Lansline Abiwatana from Ventura County. Representing Walnut Creek is Lynn Skirmerhorn. Say hello to Kimberly Ann Byers from West Los Angeles. The delegate from West San Diego is Tina Lynn Napier. Please greet Pamela Gwen Friesen from Westlake Village. Our representative from Westwood is Stacy Terry. Here from Wilmington is Stephanie Magana. And our final delegate is from Yucaipa. Please welcome Ruth Ann Day.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've just met our 95 Miss California USA pageant delegates. And let's bring them all back on the stage for a final look. And don't you agree? Don't we have a beautiful group of ladies this year? They really are something special. Good luck to all of you. Speaking of beautiful ladies, I want to introduce now a very special lady friend of mine, and she is special. She's been in the same position that our delegates are in tonight. You see, she herself was a pageant finalist. She started out by first becoming Miss Texas USA, went on to be named Miss USA in 1977. And she's tonight's hostess, and I want you to give a warm California welcome to a really special lady, Kim Tomes Dutton. Please welcome her.
Hi, Bob.
Kid.
How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Welcome
Good.
To California, you Texan, you.
Thank you.
Yeah, listen, I'm very proud because I am standing, you ready for this one, folks? I'm standing next to the Mohair Council of America spokesperson.
Yes.
What the heck is that?
Well, you know that mohair grows on little Angora goats, make the beautiful sweaters and coats.
Huh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, and you know what?
What?
Looks like you could use some mohair yourself.
Oh. Thanks a lot.
It's so terrible, isn't it? Okie dokie. You know, it's hard to believe that a year has passed and we're back in beautiful Palm Springs.
Yeah, it really is wonderful, isn't it?
Ready, we're ready here to select a new Miss California USA.
Yes, we are. And having just met our 95 statewide delegates, I think that you'll agree that our judges can really have a difficult job ahead of them tonight.
They sure do. And in just a few moments, Bob will announce for the first time the names of our 15 semifinalists. These same young ladies will reappear throughout the show in the evening gown, swimsuit, and onstage interview segment.
And by the way, also we're going to get to know a little bit better our reigning Miss California USA, Christina Faust, her predecessors, Diana Magana and Laurie Dickerson. We'll get to know them all a little bit better because they're going to be out on location here in Palm Springs by way of videotape to give you kind of a guided tour through this beautiful city.
Mm-hmm. So as you can tell, we have a lot for you to see tonight, and we know that you don't want to miss any of it. But first, let's see what Diana is doing.
As the fall season approaches, most people across the country are shopping for warm winter coats. But not here in Palm Springs. We're still in shorts and eating frozen yogurt. With average daytime temperatures in the 80s, the Indian Canyons are open daily to the public for outings and exploration. In these great canyons, which belong to the Agua Caliente band of Coahuila Indians, you can find relics and dwelling of bygone days, visit the trading post, and even go horseback riding. Want to stay outdoors? Then stop off at the Living Desert, where you'll discover 1,200 acres of open plains. You'll find a variety of prairie animals and exotic birds, miles of scenic trails, and an experience to talk about for years to come. If you're a bicycle enthusiast, then Palm Springs is the place for you. Join us on September 22nd through the 24th for this year's Bicycle Mania. With more than 35 miles of bicycle trails that run throughout the city, you can choose your course for a great afternoon of touring and fitness combined. By mid-November, the Palm Springs area will shift into high gear with the 5th annual Vintage Grand Prix. This mile-long, 7-turn course features more than 200 priceless sports and racing cars and guarantees you a roaring great time. Fall also brings a full cycle of activity at the Desert Museum, a focal point for area cultural activities. Located in the heart of Palm Springs, the museum celebrates 52 seasons of exhibitions and programs, spotlighting the best of visual arts and performing arts and natural sciences. Fall in Palm Springs is a perfect time of year. The weather is great, the sights and sounds of the desert are clear and calling. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this message from the growing line of essential personal items, Epi products.
Welcome back. Well, I've got everyone here, and we're trying to figure out who the top 15 finalists will be. What do you think, Christina?
Oh, Kent, that's not a fair question. I've been up there, and I know exactly how those girls are feeling. I only wish there could be 95 finalists.
That's true, Christina. They've all worked so hard to be here, but that's what makes them so special. As we all know, you don't have to win the crown to go home a winner.
That's right.
Okay, you guys, I think Bob's ready to start. Let's listen.
Hey, Bob is ready to start. Voting in secret, our judges have chosen 15 finalists from the 95 young ladies who represent every city, county, and area here in California. Now, the names of those 15 finalists are on the card that I am about to be handed by Carolyn. Thank you, Carolyn. I want to wish all the ladies up here the very best of luck. I wish you could all be top 15. I'll read off the names, and I'll remind everybody that I will read them off in no particular order. So if you're ready, here we go. Our first finalist, representing Gilroy, Cynthia Nelson. From Laguna Niguel, here is Jamie Barnard. They're going to be happy in Orange County, representing Anaheim, Caroline Burroughs. Look out, Los Angeles, Bonnie Bergstrom. Well, the next young lady with the opportunity to continue in tonight's competition for the title of Miss California USA is from Century City, Patricia Jacks. Thank you. Are you ready? Let's go south. From the greater San Diego County area, Kelly Prather. Representing Los Alamitos, Bethany McDonald. Oh, they're going to be happy in Beverly Hills, Natasha Pavlova. We're at the halfway mark now, seven more names to go. And our next semifinalist is from Redondo Beach, Lori Castile. Let's go north to Santa Clarita Valley, Tammy Ann Alvarez. Representing Paris, California, Brenda Hamer. You want to see a happy face? How about Tina Napier, the delegate from West San Diego? Okay. Three more names to go. Three more delegates here tonight have a chance to become the new Miss California USA for 1990. Our next semifinalist is Wendy Zastapil from Del Mar. They're happy in Hollywood, Deneen Rice. Ladies and gentlemen, just one more name will give us our 15 finalists in the Miss California USA competition. The last finalist is the representative from La Jolla, K.C. Watkins. Well, there they are, our lovely semi-finalists. One of them will be named Miss California USA for 1990. Congratulations, ladies. What a tough job our judges must have had. We have 95 very beautiful ladies on this stage. You know, throughout this busy week, our judges have had several opportunities to see all of the delegates in the Miss California USA pageant. Delegates met with each judge individually for a personality interview, with conversations held on a one-to-one basis. Now, this personality event was the first component of the preliminary judging procedure. Then last night, here at Palm Springs in the beautiful convention center, the impartial judging panel saw each of our delegates as they appeared in their official competition swimsuits from Catalina and the evening gown presentation also. By means of these presentations, our judges are given the opportunity to select the 15 best all-around young women from our group of statewide contenders. And tonight, we start all over. Our preliminary ballots have been sealed away and replaced with a new set of final ballots. The title and distinction of being named Miss California USA belongs to one of these 15 very lovely ladies. Can you guess which one the judges have chosen or will choose? Well, it won't be long and we'll all know the winner.
My first time was coming to the pageant. My second time flying was going to Puerto Rico. The first time I got on the airplane, it was so funny because I got on the airplane and I was looking out the window. Wow, we're taking off, we're taking off. We're in the air, oh my God. It was really funny. The day after I won Miss California, I went to Puerto Rico. That's when I was telling you about. They told me, they came up to me that night and they said, guess where you're going tomorrow? Uh-huh. And I said, where? They said, Puerto Rico. Uh-huh. And I said, Carolyn, where is Puerto Rico? I'm going to continue modeling for a couple of years. It's really great. I've had a great opportunity to travel all around the world. and see beautiful places and really meet some interesting people and their backgrounds and their life and how they live. And it's been really incredible. I think I'm going to continue that for a couple of years. All through my year with Guy and Rex, they're really great. They are really great. Mm-hmm. Even here this week, you guys really have a good time because it's really an incredible experience with them. If you really listen to them, you learn a lot. And it's not a mold that they're trying to put you in. It's a specialness that they bring out of you from inside. And it really is incredible, the growth that I went through my year. It's so important when you go into the judges, be yourself. Really be yourself. There is not, I was telling you guys this yesterday, when you go in there and they ask you a question about, I don't know, whatever they ask you, and you say something that you think, well, this might be a good answer, you know? This might be good. They'll like this one. Yeah. It's not true. You say from your heart, because when you speak, yeah, from your mind, you think, okay, I got them. They see it like this. They really do.
Our new Miss California USA will certainly enjoy a year's supply of New York seltzer and a sportswear wardrobe. Perfect attire for an afternoon of sightseeing. And here in Palm Springs, you can visit one of my favorite spots, Reddy's General Store. This treasured museum is an authentic recreation filled with 30s originals. How about this 80s original? Stay with us. We'll be right back after a message from the one and only New York Seltzer.
And welcome back to the Miss California USA pageant for 1990. We're here in beautiful Palm Springs. And now we have a chance to talk with each of our 15 finalists as they appear in their interview outfits, courtesy of Tommy's Tom Tom. So let's take the time now to meet all of them. Can we do that? First, representing Gilroy, here is Cynthia Nelson. Cynthia? Hi.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you excited?
I am very excited. Thank you.
Now, I understand that you've traveled. You're rubbing my back. I understand that you've traveled all over the world, to many, many countries, yet what's your favorite of all vacation spot?
My favorite vacation spot is here in Palm Springs, because since I was a small child, my family and I have come once a year to Palm Springs for 2 weeks, and we've had a lot of memories, a lot of fun, and in a way, I've grown up here in Palm Springs, so when I think back, it really is my favorite vacation spot, and I'm having a wonderful time here again. It'll add to my memories.
All right, thank you very much. The representative from Gilroy is Cynthia Nelson. Here's our representative from Laguna Niguel, Jamie Barnard. Jamie? Congratulations, Jamie.
Thank you very much.
All right, now I want to hear about an experience that you had as a long-distance swimmer at a very young age. Is that correct?
That's true. When I was 6 months old, I set a world record in swimming. Coretta Anderson was my coach, and it was set in Newport Beach, and the record was 1 minute and 52 seconds.
How far did you swim in 1 minute and 52 seconds?
The size of an Olympic pool on my back.
At 6 months of age?
That's right.
I can't swim at all right now. Do you have any advice for me?
Take lessons.
Thank you. I will. All right. From Laguna Niguel, Jamie Barnard. Here's the lovely lady, the delegate from Anaheim, Caroline Burroughs. Caroline? Is it Caroline or Carolyn?
It's Carrie, actually.
Oh, it says Caroline, and it says Carolyn, and it says, but it's Carrie.
Carrie. Caroline's my full name.
Then I'll call you Caroline.
Great.
Where do you work?
I work at Disneyland.
What do you do at Disneyland?
Well, I've done all sorts of things. I started as a dancer, and I went to Tokyo Disneyland for 7 months, and now I'm working in entertainment and promotions.
Now, I've been backstage at Disneyland, and it's sort of a society within a society, isn't it? I mean, people meet and they get married there. I mean, do you date guys from Disneyland?
Everything. Everything goes on backstage. We've got the center. We've got activities that go on all the time. It's wonderful. I've worked there for about 8 years now, and I love it.
What's Mickey really like?
Mickey? Oh, my gosh. He's wonderful.
Well, that's what I thought. Okay, thank you. From Anaheim, it's Caroline Burroughs. Thank you very much. Here representing the city of Los Angeles is Bonnie Bergstrom. Bonnie? How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Bob?
You must have butterflies.
Bumblebees or something.
Now, you come from a fairly large family, don't you?
Very large. I think very large. We have 8 children in our family.
8 children?
And a few adopted ones, strays, that kind of gradually fell in there, and my father never even recognized that they weren't his own.
How many bathrooms did you have in your house?
I think we added a few, and we had a big swimming pool.
Oh. I see. and a very busy father who I'm sure is very happy. Thank you very much. Okay, representing Los Angeles, Bonnie Bergstrom. From Century City, welcome Patricia Jacks. Patricia? Hi.
How are you?
Well, I'm excited for all 15 of you ladies. I really am. Now, we were talking about swimming a moment ago, and I understand that at one time in your life, something very exciting or almost traumatic happened to you. What was it?
Well, while vacationing at Silver Lake, my father, myself, and my brother swam out to an island, and we all had a bet to swim back. So as we were swimming back, my brother and I were a little bit ahead of my father. We both made it to the beach and then looked back, and my father was waving his arms. Immediately, I swam after him and just told my father to just stay calm and relaxed, and I would bring him in. And he did that, and I saved his life, and he's here tonight.
Isn't that a wonderful story? Thank you very much. From Century City, Patricia Jacks. Thank you. What a great story. My kids would have just waved back to me. Our representative from the greater San Diego County is this lovely lady right here. Are you ready? Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Now, you had a chance, I was told, to be an extra in a movie, and you were cast as a dancer. Now, was this with Fred Astaire, or?
No, it wasn't. Fred Astaire is my favorite actor, and I wished I could have met him before he died. But the extra I was in, the part that I had, was actually a 1920s film called The Break of Dawn. And I didn't dance. There was some waltzing in it, but I had a part that was sort of walking around in the background.
Did you get paid?
A little bit. I got paid quite a bit, but what I really enjoyed doing was reading this one particular book by Agatha Christie. And she writes a lot, and she's a very interesting woman to me. And there was a very interesting story about her that I heard and that I'd read about previously. And it said it said that she was married to a noted archaeologist. And she was interviewed by the press, and she said, "How does it feel to be married to a man who studies ancient archaeology?" And she said, "Well, an archaeologist is the best husband any woman could have, because the older she gets, the more interested he becomes in her."
I see. Okay. Our representative from the greater San Diego County area, thank you very much. Representing Los Alamitos is Bethany McDonald. Bethany, right over here. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Now, you're a singer, correct?
Yes, I am.
You sing professionally?
I can sing it professionally, but I don't get paid for it.
Oh, I do the same thing. But you have one advantage over me. Is it true you have perfect pitch?
I would like to think so. Yes, I do. Yes.
Let me try you out. Bum.
Bum.
Oh, I know. That's my same bum, but what key is that?
Can you do that one more time?
Bum.
F?
You could have fooled me. I don't know.
It's
if
F.
You say it's F, I believe it's you. F. I thought you were going to say it B flat, but I guess not. Thank you. Representing Los Alamitos, Bethany McDonald. Thank you very much. Here from Beverly Hills is Natasha Pavlova. Hi.
Hi.
How you feel?
I feel very excited. My family is all here. And I'm very thankful for all their support.
Now, Pavlova is a Yugoslavian name, am I correct?
Yes, it is. It's also a Russian name. But Yugoslavia means the land of the southern Slavs.
Means what?
Land of the southern Slavs.
What? That's hard to say. What does Pavlova mean?
My aunt has been researching our family genealogy, and she discovered that Pavle was one of my great-great-great-grandfathers. And so we have a tradition in Yugoslavia, like the Russians do, that we take on the great-great-grandfather's name. So his name was Pavle, so I am Pavlova, the son or daughter of Pavle.
Trust me, you're the daughter.
Yes.
Thank you very much. From Beverly Hills, Natasha Pavlova. Well, those are the first of our 15 finalists. One of these contestants may very well be our new Miss California USA for 1990.
Now remember, we still have 7 more interviews to go, plus swimsuit and evening gown competition. And now here's Diana with some more exciting news about Palm Springs.
The winter season is a magical time of year here in Palm Springs. Throughout the month of December, the city's famed Palm Canyon Drive will twinkle with thousands of white Christmas lights.
For an exciting mountaintop adventure, you can escape into the Mount San Jacinto Wilderness by the way of the Palm Springs Aerial Tramway. You will find a snowy wonderland with excellent cross-country skiing, overnight camping, and daytime hiking expeditions. Special events during the season include the world-renowned Moosehead Championship Sled Dog Races, the annual Christmas tree lighting ceremony, and if you're lucky, you may even run into Santa Claus himself. The Palm Springs Opera Guild is active all season, offering Sunday afternoon concerts, classic ballet performances, and opera productions. In addition, the Desert Museum becomes a winter showcase for special symphony performances, string quartet appearances, and holiday piano recitals. Palm Springs also has countless art galleries which hold frequent exhibitions, auctions, demonstrations, and sales. Artists and their work are on display in featured gallery shows and receptions throughout the city. Charity events and formal holiday galas fill the winter calendar as local organizations use their holiday season for black tie fundraisers. From champagne receptions to Christmas balls and gourmet dinners, the social scene is both colorful and part of everyone's daily conversation.
Music, art, craft shows, and charity balls are all hallmarks of the winter season here in the desert. After the holidays, Mayor Sonny Bono will host the first Palm Springs International Film Festival. So mark your calendars now for January 10th through the 14th. We'll be back to show you more about our beautiful host city, Palm Springs, after this message from your Southern California Chevrolet dealers.
Welcome back to the Miss California USA pageant for 1990. And let's continue now as we get to know the rest of our finalists just a little bit better. And our next semifinalist we want to talk to represents the city of Redondo Beach, Lori Castile. Lori? Hi.
Hi, Bob. How are you?
Boy, you talk about a busy family. Now, this lady works for an airline, but what I was fascinated about is that what does your father do?
My father, well, first of all, he works full-time for a Honda store as a service manager, but in his spare time, he races cars. Not only does he race them, but he builds them, and he builds the motors, and he rebuilds motors, and trailers, and race boats, and you name it. He basically lives in the garage.
I'm sorry. Is that your mother's choice or your father's choice?
No, I think that after 25 years, she's learned to live with it, and now she has her own thing and sells Avon. And I also have a little sister who's 10 who keeps her quite busy. And then there's me competing in all these beauty pageants. And she really enjoys coming to all of them. It really makes her feel special to be a part of my life.
You're a very special lady. Thank you very much. Representing the city of Redondo Beach is Lori Castile. Our delegate from Santa Clarita Valley is Tammy Ann Alvarez. Tammy Ann? Step right up here, my dear. Hi.
Hi, Bob.
Okay, now let me go through this if I can. You're a very accomplished young lady. That you are pursuing a career related to journalism, language arts, and politics. Now, what are you going to do with all this?
Well, I plan to graduate from college and kind of work my way up so that way I don't have to go directly into a field that I know nothing about. My career goals are to eventually become an active politician, but I'd rather work my way up starting as a journalist so that I can feel my way and learn a little bit more about politics, and then work up to maybe news reporting or mass media, and then eventually become a politician.
Why not? I mean, it sounds to me that if you go to journalism and then a politician, now your career's going the wrong direction, hon, you know?
No, because you can learn more about the field by being placed in the center of it.
Well, I'm sure whatever you want, you're going to get. Thank you very much. Representing the Santa Clarita Valley is Tamian Alvarez. Here from Paris, California, is Brenda Hamer. Brenda? Hi.
Hi, Bob.
All right, where's Paris, California?
Paris is in France, Bob. No, 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 I had to do that. You've been giving us jokes all day, and all night, I should say. Paris is in Riverside County.
Oh. You threw me for a loop there for a moment. Now, you're a nature lover, is that right?
Yes, I am. I've been fortunate to have grown up in a very rural community, and I've raised everything from barn owls to skunks, and I'd have to say my most favorite animal of all was my 7-foot African rock python.
You had a snake?
I sure did.
You still do?
No, we sold him.
How much does a 7-foot African python bring in the market today?
Actually, I don't know what the price on them right now is. I think I sold them for about $500 about 5 years ago.
Were you dating at the time?
No, I wasn't.
Can you imagine picking up the lady with a 7-foot snake around her neck? Hi, we're ready to go. You're a very nice lady. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob.
All right, representing Paris is Brenda Hamer. And now from West San Diego is Tina Napier. Hi. You too are pursuing a career now in a very interesting avocation, by the way. This lady is pursuing a career with the Theater for the Deaf. How'd you get interested in that?
Well, I started out in about 8th grade. I had one of those free periods. And we had an elementary school across the street. And so I spent 40 minutes every day in the hard of hearing class. And I got to work with a lot of very special young children. They taught me how to sign. And they taught me that even if you have a handicap, you have something else to offer. So that got me interested, and I've been pursuing it ever since.
Congratulations to you. It's a wonderful goal. Thank you very much. All right, from West San Diego's Tina Napier. Tina? And now here comes Wendy Zastapil from Del Mar. Wendy? How do you feel? Feel good?
I feel great.
Now, I heard a story about you, about a semi-truck and an accident, and it's a very fascinating story. Why don't you relate it to our audience?
Well, on the 3rd of July, 1973, my brother and I were playing Tonkas in the front yard of...
Playing what?
Tonkas.
As in trucks?
Yes.
Oh, Tonka toys. Oh, okay.
Yes, I was a scooper truck. We had lived in the house for 2 weeks, and it was a brand new house with no grass yet. And someone had parked a double trailer semi-truck on a hill, and the brakes gave out and made its way in through the garage and out the back of the house. My brother's bedspread was spread across the front of the truck, and it was his nap time. Luckily, we were playing in the front yard, and my mother was in the kitchen, safe. One of the only rooms in the house that was safe. And my father had left the garage to go to the store to get a part for the dryer. So it was a very fortunate experience.
Well, I bet you thought those Tonka trucks had multiplied, didn't you? What an interesting story. Thank you very much for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
Okay. Wendy Zastapil from Del Mar. Here comes Deneen Rice from the city of Hollywood. Deneen? Hi. I can't wait to talk to you about this one.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I heard. Is it true?
What?
You had a blind date with Sylvester Stallone?
Yes, it is. As soon as I won the Miss Hollywood pageant, my picture was put on a friend of mine's, her agent's desk, and he happened to see the picture, and he wanted to meet me, and so she called me and set me up on a blind date with him.
How'd it go?
It was fantastic. It was great to meet him. He's not at all like you would think he is.
He talks like this.
He's really a nice man. And I couldn't believe, was really excited, and I couldn't believe that I was sitting next to him, eating my salad, going, I can't believe this is Sylvester Stallone sitting next to me.
And he said, yo.
Yo, Deneen.
Yo, Deneen, thank you very much. From Hollywood, Deneen Rice. Our final delegate comes to us from La Jolla. She is K.C. Watkins. K.C.? Hi.
How are you doing?
All right, I know you've been asked, but what does KC stand for?
KC stands for Karen Charisse.
So that's a very pretty name. Why don't you use Karen Charisse Watkins?
I've been in this pageant before, and I've used Karen Charisse because I think it's a pretty name too, but it just doesn't fit me, and nobody knows who I am, and I don't answer to it.
You know, I have the same problem. I did the Miss USA and Miss Universe pageant under the name of Bob Barker, and they haven't asked me back either, you know?
I can understand that.
What do you mean by that?
You don't.
No, never mind. You chase dolphins, is that true?
Well, I did it once. I live in La Jolla, and it's a beautiful area, and we have a lot of dolphins that play off the coast. And one day I borrowed my brother-in-law's surfboard, and I swam out, which was funny because I can't surf, and I had a hard time staying on the surfboard. But once I got out there, I tried to get close enough to the dolphins, but they wouldn't let me near. So I decided I'll just watch them from the beach.
Don't blame me. That's where I watch them, too. Okay? Thank you very much. From La Jolla's K.C. Watkins. Well, thanks to all of our ladies. Once again, here are the lovely finalists that we just met.
I'm here in the audience with our panel of judges, a group of nine very special people who have the task of choosing that one young lady who will represent California throughout the next year and in the Miss USA pageant next spring. Now remember, each of our judges votes in secret, so no one knows who's ahead at this point. It won't be long before you'll see our 15 semifinalists as they appear in the swimsuit competition, and you won't want to miss that.
Our new Miss California USA will enjoy a special collection of designer day wear from Los Angeles-based Barbara Barbara. Beautiful designs against a beautiful Palm Springs Convention Center complex. Tucked beneath the towering San Jacinto Mountains, this premier facility houses over 100,000 square feet of meeting and exhibit space, right here in the heart of Palm Springs. Don't go away. We'll be right back with more of our Miss California USA pageant. From, you guessed it, sunny Palm Springs, California's desert centerpiece.
It's white, it's water, it's Williams. Our representative from Gilroy, Cynthia Nelson. The delegate, Jamie Barnard from Laguna Niguel, and Carolyn Burroughs from Anaheim.
Bonnie Bergstrom comes to us from Los Angeles, and Patricia Jacks comes to us from Century City. Representing Greater San Diego County is Kelly Prather. And representing Los Alamitos is Bethany McDonald. Our next delegate is from Beverly Hills, and she is Natasha Pavlova. Along with Lori Castile from Redondo Beach. She is Tammy Ann Alvarez, and she's from Santa Clarita Valley. Along with Brenda Hamer, who comes to us from Paris, California. Tina Napier represents West San Diego. And Wendy Zastapil represents Del Mar. Our final two delegates include Deneen Rice from Hollywood and Casey Watkins from La Jolla. Ladies and gentlemen, our 15 finalists in our swimsuit competition. Aren't they beautiful?
Batter up. That's a cry of spring as Gene Autry's California Angels play other baseball teams during spring training here at Angel Stadium. Or you can enjoy Music Fest, held in late April or early May, and featuring some of the best musical entertainment in the country. Or why not take a stroll into one of the world's greatest shopping experiences? The Desert Fashion Plaza is just one of the many shopping areas throughout the city to choose from. There's something for every taste and budget. But be sure and leave yourself enough time to enjoy some of the world's finest restaurants the desert area has to offer. From fresh seafood to exotic Greek and Mexican specialties, the choice is endless. For a unique experience and a spectacular view of the desert and mountains, soar above the valley floor on a warm desert breeze in a hot air balloon and enjoy the Palm Springs Gordon Bennett Balloon Race. You can also take a guided 1 and 2 hour tour to the homes of celebrities, movie stars, elite country clubs, and attractions in Palm Springs area. Why not take a step back in time and visit the original homes of Miss Cornelia White and the legendary McCallum family? Built in the late 1800s, both structures represent the earliest settlings of the Palm Springs area. Palm Springs is known as the golf capital of the world. Nearly 80 lush green championship courses bring rookies and pros alike to the desert for the challenge. Quite simply, it's where you can come to play the best or watch the best play. Palm Springs has over 7,500 swimming pools, one for every five people. The city swim center at Sunrise Plaza boasts an Olympic-sized pool and activities that range from lap swims to water exercise to splashing with the kids. And it's open year-round to the public.
I think my favorite outdoor sport has to be sunbathing. And in Palm Springs, a year-round tan is easy to pick up. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this message from the original New York Seltzer.
Power will have the name of our new Miss California USA for 1990. But before we go any further, tell you what let's do. Here's a special look at a very special lady.
But I can just as easily, and I mean this honestly, put on a pair of shorts and put my hair in a ponytail and take off half my makeup. Not all of it, just half of it. And feel just the same as I feel now. Belief is the strongest power that you can have. It really is. And if you believe in yourself, and if you have a goal, by George, for heaven's sakes, you guys better stick with it and walk out of here a winner for life. Every one of you already are, but make it count. Make every day count, okay? The new Miss California is one, it's gonna be one lucky girl, I'll tell you, because she's gonna have a great time, and she's gonna have a wonderful experience, experience of a lifetime. I get choked up because it means a lot, you know, and it took a lot of work. But I'm sorry, you guys. It's just, it was a year of my life, and it was a really meaningful year. And those experiences, I wish that I could tell you all. Really, what I mean, I feel like you're not feeling what I'm feeling, you know, and I guess you just have to live through it. You have to go through it. I can relay some of it to you, but a lot of it I can't. But I just hope you have a good time, okay? And I love you all. Okay? All right. That's all I have to say. Okay. I'm done talking. Cut.
I kind of felt the same way when they canceled the Newlywed Game, if you want to know the truth. As you saw earlier in the show, our judges have been busy with preliminary events, and tonight is certainly no exception. They've had a difficult job ahead of them as they choose our Miss California USA for 1990. And I would like to introduce them now. Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet our distinguished panel of judges. If you're ready, here we go. This Hollywood casting director owns the Tepper Gallegos Casting Company, the largest commercial casting company in Los Angeles, casting for such companies as McDonald's, Toyota, and Chevrolet. He's recently casted Eddie Murphy's primetime smash, What's Alan Watching? He's completed, by the way, a Jackson video that he cast, and he's just one of the top casting directors in the country with the best commercial workshop in the country. Please say hello to Dennis Gallegos. Our next judge is the director of public relations at Epe Products. She's been instrumental in success of the Epilady hair removal device and has helped introduce several new products, such as Epi Smile. A former freelance publicist, please greet Susanna Wilson. An international recording star, our next judge has three gold records, over 60 LPs, and performs in styles ranging from jazz to country to pop. His latest LP, Moving On, will be out this month. Here is Buddy Greco. What a lovely lady she is. Miss USA of 1988, our next judge calls Fort Worth, Texas, her home, but is currently working in Los Angeles. An elite model, she is now pursuing an exciting career in acting. Here is the very lovely Courtney Gibbs. Vice President of Media for Vic Olson and Partners, our next judge represents the Chevrolet Geo Division of General Motors. Give a warm Palm Springs welcome to Lee J. Wilson. A popular interior designer and showroom owner in Los Angeles, our next judge was born and raised in Switzerland. If you would please welcome Gina B.
You may have seen him on the AB series Coach, or catch him in the soon-to-be-released movie Fatal Charm. This actor and model was launched into his career by exposure in Faces International magazine. Please greet John Michael Alves. She is Senior Vice President of Western International Media Corporation, where she supervises the Epi Products account. Formerly with the J. Walter Thompson Advertising Agency, she has taught advertising at UCLA. And here is Donna Wall. And our final judges for the evening has been the fur fashion industry, has been in the fur fashion industry for 43 years as a partner of Gaiba Noblia Incorporated in Beverly Hills. Having worked closely with many top West Coast designers and show business, he is now in the couturier field of fashion. Please greet Joe Noblia. Ladies and gentlemen, our official panel of judges and our pageant auditor this evening is from Pete Merwick, Main & Company in Los Angeles, Mr. Tim Benson. There they are, our fine panel of judges. Kim?
Hi. Palm Springs has always been known as the playground of the stars, and our delegates certainly felt like stars this past week as they were welcomed to special parties and events held in their honor. Just watch.
With a host of parties and events to fill their 9-day schedule of activities, our delegates were eager and ready to go. And their first stop was at contestant orientation. On hand to greet our girls were pageant director Richard Guy, reigning Miss California USA Christina Faust, and former state queens Lori Dickerson and Diana Magana. Local representatives from Epi Products treated our delegates to a special day of beauty. Our girls tried out all of the latest products to include the relaxing EpiPed, the steaming facial sauna, and the popular Epilady. Souvenirs from the day included neon bright Epi shirts. Then it was off to the Oasis Water Resort, Palm Springs' popular beachfront. After a leisurely float around the lazy river and a splash on the tube slide, our girls were quick to serve with a standoff game of volleyball. It was the New York Souser Slicks versus the Epi Ladies. A buffet dinner was a welcome sight along with an afternoon of sun and fun. Hawaiian Tropic was on hand to gift our contestants with a special collection of suntan products. Joining Christina at the Palm Springs Senior Center was our Miss California teen, Micheline Bonilla. The girls had a chance to welcome local senior citizens at a special meet-and-greet luncheon and visit with the organizers of the annual Cantree Project, an effort our contestants participated in as well. And then it was off to this year's Hollywood Fantasy Party at Pompey's Restaurant and Club in Cathedral City. Christina arrived in grand style courtesy of Heimer Helicopter and found time for a few quick autographs. Our stars were dressed for the occasion and treated to a feast of delectables before taking to the dance floor, complete with a state-of-the-art light and sound system. The competition was in full swing with the announcement of our 5 finalists. Marilyn Monroe, disguised as Miss Newport Beach, was tonight's best costume winner. The days were filled with show rehearsals in preparation for tonight's live telecast, but a welcome break gave Amera Cosmetics a chance to gift all of our contestants with a special hand and nail care kit. Then it was time to meet the media for the annual Miss California USA press party. In preparation, Cameo Coutures of Dallas presented all of our delegates with terry wraparound robes. The Vidal Sassoon division of the Helen of Troy Corporation gifted our girls with special curling irons, and Soto Santi sandals from Irvine provided sandals and mix and match pasta laces for our contestants' enjoyment. Our delegates were also the lucky recipients of the newest invention, Towel Huggers by Emmy, perfect for that sun-tanning afternoon. Gathered around the lush gardens and pool at the beautiful Palm Springs Hilton Hotel, the festivities gave local photographers a chance to meet the girls and select this year's Miss Photogenic. On hand to help announce this prestigious award was Hilton's Director of Sales, Craig Stahl. And the winner was Miss Redondo Beach. Congratulations.
What a great time we've had here in Palm Springs, and we would like to thank all of the many people who have made this time so wonderful, sorry about that, in entertaining our pageant delegates. It's been great fun, and we hope to do it again next year. Our evening gown competition is coming up soon, followed by the announcement of our top 5 finalists, so there's lots more to see. But first, here's Christina.
Designer Ruth Beth Wagner of Los Angeles presents our new Miss California USA with a collection of wonderful leather designs, perfect for our grand tour of our host city, Palm Springs. There's so much to see here, from celebrity homes to desert resorts to countless recreational facilities. We'll show you more on this desert showpiece, Palm Springs, after this message from Lunch Bucket. Microwavable meals, a proper hot lunch.
Now let's get ready for our evening gown presentation and the Phantom of the Opera. First finalist is from Gilroy, Cynthia Nelson. Next is Jamie Barnard from Laguna Niguel. Representing Anaheim, Caroline Burrows. Bonnie Bergstrom comes to us from Los Angeles. Century City sends us Patricia Jax. Representative from Greater San Diego County is Kelly Prather. Bethany McDonald from Los Alamitos. Representing Beverly Hills, Natasha Pavlova. Delegate from Redondo Beach, Lori Castile. Here comes Tammy Ann Alvarez from Santa Clarita Valley. Welcome, Brenda Hamer from Paris, California. Next, we have Tina Napier from West San Diego. Representing Del Mar, Wendy Zestapil. is Deneen Rice from Hollywood. Finalist in the evening gown presentation, K.C. Watkins from La Jolla. Aren't they beautiful, though? Judges, take a closer look at our 15 finalists as they compete for the title of Miss California USA for 1990.
There is just so much to do in Palm Springs this summer that you'll wish your vacation could last just a few days longer. Believe it or not, Palm Springs has its own beach. The Oasis Water Resort has 1,500 feet of free fall and speed slides and the biggest wave pool in California. If you're a surfer or just want to relax in your own private inner tube, forget the long hot drive to the beach. Surf's up in Palm Springs. After a day of active recreation, you can relax in the evening by enjoying the special series of concerts in the park. Featured live entertainment greets you along with the city's free pop and jazz concerts on the lawn at Sunrise Plaza. Or you can cheer on the spirited Palm Springs Angels as they play the country's wildest, most enthusiastic Class A California League clubs. These future major leaguers go to bat at the Palm Springs Angels Stadium, complete with traditional hot dogs and peanuts. It's your serve, as more than 300 tennis courts are ready for play. Many of the popular surfaces are open to the public and lighted for night play. Palm Springs has really become the sports lover's heaven, and its 350 sunny days a year make tennis a year-round sport. Help celebrate Uncle Sam's birthday with new and old friends, the old-fashioned way. Angel Stadium in Sunrise Park sets the stage for a sky ablaze with fireworks and color. A summer picnic with all the fixins and a taste of the red, white, and blue are all you need to celebrate the 4th in grand style. A good way to keep in tip-top shape and meet some of the locals is at the Palm Springs Leisure Center. You'll find fitness and dance classes, aerobics and yoga, in addition to specially designed programs for children of all ages. And finally, the Palm Springs Convention Center hosts the Miss California USA pageant. Held each summer, our statewide delegates gather in competition for our state's most coveted title. Our Miss California USA pageant has become the glamour event of the season, something you won't want to miss. Palm Springs has a relaxed and friendly atmosphere, gloriously warm days, a full sports and entertainment menu, and best of all, the world's greatest yogurt. Don't go away. We'll be right back after this message from Penguin's frozen yogurt.
The pageant. This next young lady was the judge's pick, and I think you'll understand why. So give a warm California welcome to Miss Texas USA for 1990, Stephanie Cuney. Steph?
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Welcome. Welcome to California.
Thank you.
As I mentioned, it was just been 6 weeks now since she's been named Miss Texas for 1990, and I understand that already your traveling schedule has just been crazy. Is that right?
That is true, Bob. I arrived here in Palm Springs earlier this week from appearances in Seattle and New Orleans, and just 3 weeks ago, I had the opportunity to spend a wonderful weekend in Poland. In fact, I've been so busy, I haven't been able to go home to Houston since I was crowned.
I bet the Poles thought Poland was a really interesting way of saying
right.
Their country, wasn't
yes.
it? At the time that you entered this pageant, did you realize that your schedule would be this hectic and crazy?
No, I really didn't. You know, everybody tells the girls what it's like, but you never really know until you're going through it yourself. But I can tell you this much, it's an opportunity I wouldn't trade for anything in the world. And in just a short time, I've learned so much. I know that the rest of this year is going to be very special.
Well, I'm sure it will, because you're a special lady. And I know that you
Thank
have
you.
Some guests out there you want to introduce. Is that correct?
I sure do, Bob.
Okay.
I'm very pleased to introduce, from our beautiful host city, the mayor of Palm Springs, Sonny Bono, and his lovely wife, Mary. I have just returned from a wonderful trip in New Orleans where I paired with one of our pageant sponsors, New York Seltzer. And joining us tonight is Alan Miller, co-founder and chairman of Original New York Seltzer, and Randy Miller, co-founder and president of Original New York Seltzer. We're also delighted to welcome beauty and talent expert Mark Burnett, Corporate Vice President of Faces International, the entertainment industry's resource for new talent. We're also especially delighted to welcome Cheryl Rosen, Director of New Product Development and Packaging for Epilady. Hair removal devices, Epi Sensation Skincare, and Epi Smile Tooth Whitener and Cleanser. Also joining us tonight is Mr. Ron Ryder from the Penguin Frozen Yogurt Corporation. Another special guest in our audience is the president of the Southern California Chevrolet Dealers. And we all know that our new Miss California USA drives off tonight in her brand new Chevrolet Cavalier convertible. Please welcome Mr. Tom Bell. We would also like to acknowledge our scholarship sponsors. A new Miss California USA will receive a special $10,000 cash award, which is made available by the Vidal Sassoon Division of the Helen of Troy Corporation. Hawaiian Tropic, the Freedom Bowl, and Diana's Mexican Food Product Corporation. Thanks to all of our special guests for joining us tonight. Here's Bob.
Thank you, Stephanie. Good job. And good
Thank
luck.
Thank you.
At the Miss USA pageant, too. Well, our
Bye-bye.
Auditors have finished their work, and now they're ready to hand me the announcement for our top five finalists. This is where it gets really exciting. Here we go. One of the next girls that I announce will become our new Miss California USA for 1990. So on this card are the names of the five young women who will move one step closer. Our first finalist is from Hollywood, Deneen Rice. Our second finalist, from Los Angeles, Bonnie Bergstrom. Just three more names to go. Our next finalist comes to us from Redondo Beach, Lori Castile. All right, our fourth finalist represents Gilroy, Cynthia Nelson. One more name remains, just one more chance to continue in the competition for the title of Miss California USA for 1990, and that name is Tina Napier, West San Diego.
Well, congratulations to all of our finalists. Oh, boy. Now, we get to have a chance to have a final look at each of our five finalists. You know, our new Miss California USA not only needs to have poise, personality, and beauty of face and figure, but she should also have the talent of being a spokesperson. So each of our finalists will now have a chance to showcase her on-air abilities by means of our top five commercials. So why don't we start right now? I'll find the right girl. Here we go. Okay. The representative from Hollywood. Good luck.
Thank you.
It's a brand new day, California style, live from Palm Springs. Join us as 95 statewide California beauties salute the Golden State and vie for the title and distinction of being Miss California USA 1990.
Deneen Rice from Hollywood. Here's Bonnie Bergstrom from Los Angeles.
California, vacation and entertainment capital of the world. Take a sightseeing trip and come visit us. We're the country's most exciting state, and we're not afraid to brag about it.
Thank you, Bonnie. Representing Redondo Beach is Lori Castile.
Interested in a year of excitement, travel, and a heck of a good time? Now's your chance to sign up for the Miss California USA pageant. Don't delay, send for an application. Who knows, you may be the next Miss USA.
Thank you, Lori. Cynthia Nelson represents the city of Gilroy. Cynthia?
There's always something going on in Palm Springs, regardless of the time of year. So get in on the fun, good music, and festivities. Enjoy a city that's the best kept secret in Southern California. Palm Springs, the desert centerpiece.
Finally, Tina Napier from West San Diego.
Lori Dickerson, Diana Magana, and Christina Faust are all part of California tradition. One of us are to follow that tradition. And who knows, one of us may be Miss California USA, and to follow that, Miss USA.
Very good, finalists. You did an excellent job. You really did. Well, it won't be long now. We'll have the names of our four runners-up and our new Miss California USA for 1990. So, ladies, thank you very much.
There are so many types of beauties in California that you have to keep in mind that any one of you could be a Miss California. I competed for Miss California three times. And at the times I thought I was ready, I realized I wasn't. You gotta always broaden your mind and don't set limitations, because that's when all your goals and all your dreams will end. If it doesn't happen, it wasn't meant to be. You have to be honest with yourself and say to yourself, have I done everything? Have I done all my homework to really win this title? Or do I want it for other reasons? And again, be careful for what you want, because you just might get it. And when you get it, you might not have wanted it.
Palm Springs is never hard to get to. Just a 2-hour drive from Los Angeles, or you take one of 10 airlines serving the Palm Springs Regional Airport. As easy as it is to get to this beautiful desert city, it's almost impossible to leave. Quite simply, you may never want to go home. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this message from your Southern California Chevrolet dealer.
Here in tonight's show, our winners will be a recipient of a prize package valued at over $70,000. So, using our host hotels as our location backgrounds, here's a look at all of the wonderful prizes our new Miss California USA will receive this year.
The best of the best, the Palm Springs Hilton Hotel and Los Angeles designer Beverly Standing. Tonight's winner will certainly make her statement in these wardrobe essentials. Dr. Nancy Johnson, founder of Amera Cosmetics, gifts our Golden State Queen with an array of hand and nail care products for long-lasting and healthy nails. Palm Springs' newest vacation getaway, the Hampton Inn, showcases our winner's special daywear ensemble from popular California designer Robert Krugman. Our state queen will have a full year of travel this next year, and American Airlines will help make it memorable with a special week's visit to Paris, France, Europe's number one vacation site. The famous Gene Autry Hotel, a Palm Springs original, creates poolside delight for Miss California USA with a collection of Sunset Beach swimwear by Catalina of Los Angeles. And to help capture the perfect California tan, Hawaiian Tropic gifts our winner with a product collection ranging from oils to sunscreens to lotions. Los Angeles designer Jane Singer provides our queen with the ideal daywear collection featuring soft, prints, and solids. Perfect for her reign as this year's annual Freedom Bowl Queen in Anaheim during the Christmas holiday season. One of Palm Springs' finest small hotels is Casa Cody, who welcomes Opal Designs by Hot Property. And tonight's winner will enjoy a wardrobe of chic sportswear for fun and travel. And how about these handcrafted designer boots from Texas-based Dalian Boot Company? Miss California USA will certainly be one of a kind in her Western gear. And she'll enjoy a complete 100-watt JVC home audio system from Mad Jack Sound Specialist in San Diego. World-renowned for its health and mineral springs, the Spa Hotel sets its scene for our winner's collection of dressy daytime fashions from California's B&B collection. And she's off to the newest Dutch beach resort in Swain Wharf, Aruba, Harbor Town, offering the best in shopping and vacationing in the Caribbean. It's home away from home at the Oasis Villa Hotel. And what better way to relax than with her complete line of essential personal items from Epi products, with everything from facial saunas to foot care. A tradition begins as Miss California USA will be the envied recipient of the spectacular Esmeralda necklace created by H. Stern. This replica jewelry neck piece represents the new Stouffer Esmeralda Resort in Indian Wells and will be a treasured addition to the Miss California USA prize package. Our Golden State beauty will keep a busy schedule this next year, and Cameo Coutures of Dallas will help her meet the evenings with a full collection of nightgowns, robes, and loungers, all in the resort surroundings of Palm Springs Vacations International. And for her enjoyment during this next year, Los Angeles interior designer Gina B. sends this femininely styled chaise lounge. From hair setters to curling irons to blow dryers, Miss California USA will find an array of hair care appliances from the Vidal Sassoon division of the Helen of Troy Corporation. The popular Shiloh Hotel on Palm Canyon Drive greets our state queen in these exclusive separates styled in 100% silk from P.J. Lingberg of Los Angeles. With an assortment of European designer footwear from R&S Footwear in Houston, Texas. It's the suite life here at the Sharona Lodge, and Bum Equipment adds the icing to the cake as our queen enjoys her collection of casual sportswear from Chauvin International in Los Angeles. What better way to keep in touch than with a cellular phone? And GTE of California provides tonight's winner with her own private line of modern communication. The lure of mariachis and afternoon siestas awaits our winner as she visits our neighboring sister country of Mexico, courtesy of Mexicana Airlines. With accommodations provided by the popular beach resort, the Lapa Lapa Hotel. The exquisite Maximes de Paris Suite Hotel finds its enduring elegance matched as our state queen arrives in these silk cocktail and evening wear fashions from Los Angeles designer Luisa Nevins. Diamonds are a girl's best friend, and tonight's winner will be the sparkle of any evening for the next year with her gold and diamond jewelry wardrobe courtesy of Zales. Jiva Noblia of Los Angeles and Beverly Hills, designers of fine furs, presents our state beauty with a full-length black mink coat, one of the finest designs in America. Vacation International welcomes Miss California USA to Mazatlan, sparkling gem of the Mexican coastline. The elegance of the Marquis Hotel continues to distinguish itself among all others and provides the perfect backdrop for our Queen's ensemble of dazzling evening wear designs from San Martin International. handcrafted by Master Jewel of El Paso, Texas, the official Miss California USA crown ring is designed in 18 karat gold and 24 diamonds and eagerly awaits the name of its new owner. The Wyndham Hotel, a desert classic, creates the set for our winner's wardrobe of leather designs for both day and evening wear, courtesy of Tannery West in Hayward. Our state queen will certainly turn a few heads as she enters the room in her stunning designer cocktail and evening gown collection from Guy Rex. And she drives off from the Miss California USA pageant in her new automatic, fully loaded Cavalier convertible from the Southern California Chevrolet dealer.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the gifts, the travel, the fame, all of these things that come as part of being named Miss California USA can never take the place of the memories that our young ladies take with them. Here's Christina Faust, our very special Miss California USA. And joining Christina on our stage is Miss California USA 1988, Diana Magana. Miss California USA 1987, Lori Dickerson. And it gives me a great pleasure to introduce on our stage our executive producers of Miss California USA pageant. Please welcome Richard Guy and Rex Holt.
Chris, Christina has been a fabulous Miss California. She had some words to say to you tonight, but we want to catch up with the show. All I can do is say, Christina, we love you. You've been fabulous. Guy and I, with the help of Orpheus Crystal, are presenting all three of our Guy Rex girls, from Diana to Lori to Christina, our first three from California. We love them. They've done a great job. Christina, Lori, Diana, thank you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, our Miss California USA's Christina Faust, Diana Magana, and Lori Dickerson, and thanks, of course, to the fabulous Guy Rex.
Sportswear separates from Catalina are a must in the Miss California USA wardrobe. And the perfect complement are these accessories from Soto Santi. Sandals, mix and match laces, sunglasses, our choice for a visit to Morton's Botanical Gardens. This famous living museum features beautiful nature trails and several thousand varieties of desert plants. And after a long day of exploring, what could be better than a relaxing shower with Episage? I'm on my way home, but we'll be right back after these words from, who else? Episage.
Well, our judges have finished their work, our auditor has completed the tallying, and I believe that all-important list is now ready. So here we go. Good luck to our five finalists. You got it for me? Okay, here we go. On this card are the names of the runners-up in the 1990 Miss California USA pageant. Good luck to each and everybody, each and every one of you, I should say. Here we go. Our fourth runner-up to the title of Miss California USA is Tina Napier, representing West San Diego. The third runner-up from Redondo Beach, Lori Castile. The second runner-up for the title of Miss California USA is Bonnie Bergstrom from Los Angeles. Okay, two remaining finalists. Ladies, would you please step right down here with me? Come on down here, if you would. In just about 30 seconds now, one of these ladies will be announced as our first runner-up. The other will be our new Miss California USA, winning a brand new Chevrolet Cavalier convertible, a full-length mink coat, jewelry, and wardrobe, all worth over $70,000. Here we go. You ready? The first runner-up is Deneen Rice of Hollywood, our new Miss California USA from Gilroy, California, Cynthia Nelson. The cash, the awards, all the wonderful prizes are hers. And she'll also be representing our state in the annual Miss USA pageant this next spring. And I know she's going to be excited, but right now, Cynthia, take that all-important walk, if you would, please, and show everyone just how happy and how pretty you really are to be the new Miss California USA for 1990. And look
Marquess waiting for at the end of the ramp. It's her own Chevrolet Cavalier convertible from the Southern California Chevrolet dealers. And it's hers to keep and enjoy for many years to come. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's Miss California USA. I'm Bob Eubanks for Kim Tomes Dutton saying thank you very much, Palm Springs, and we'll see you next year. Bye-bye.
The 1990 Miss California USA pageant has been brought to you by Chevrolet and your Southern California Chevrolet dealers. And by Epi Products, the people who bring you Epilady and a growing line of other beauty breakthroughs. And Original New York Seltzer, light and refreshing, the choice is clear. And by Lunch Bucket, microwavable meals, a proper hot lunch. And Vaughn's, finally, a store that works. Our California USA winners will receive the beautiful Orr-Force Residence Bowls from Orr-Force Crystal, handcrafted from the finest bullet crystal, and available at the Crystal Court, Costa Mesa, and Orr-Force New York Gallery. Uncover the world's greatest designers, the Greif Companies, featuring leading labels in men's tailored clothing and formal wear. Made in the USA from the Greif Companies. Portions of this program have been pre-recorded.
The lights, Freddy's back. Freddy's Nightmares, A Nightmare on Elm Street, the series, next.